Hi everyone, I'm Kyle Shewfelt from Calgary, and today I'm going to be recounting my routine from the 2004 Athens Olympic Games, where I ended up winning a gold medal. As I stood in the corner of the floor, I was trying to repeat positive mantras to myself. I was taking deep breaths and I could feel my heart beating in my ears. As I stepped onto the floor, I said out loud, "Make it happen." It was all about letting go and letting the work happen. I needed to maintain good rhythm through this first tumbling pass, and I knew it was critical to stick it. And when I did, I had an explosion of fireworks in my mind. My second pass, I heard someone in the audience yell, "Go, Kyle!" But I maintained focus. During the middle section of my routine, it was all about the execution. It was about the style and trying to stand out. That's what I had made a reputation for myself as, one of the most stylish gymnasts. And I knew that it would be the one thing that could separate me from the rest of the field. This handstand, I had been performing handstands for my entire life, and this was the longest one. It felt like 20 seconds, but in reality it was only 2. Before my final tumbling pass, I kept saying to myself, "Stick it, Kyle. You have to stick this. Stick it." Urgency came over me as I did my round of back handspring, double twisting, double back, and I nailed it. I don't know what happened here. This was me, just a release of emotion. And I ran down those steps and I jumped into a hug and a high five with my coach, Kelly Manjack. Now, this man coached me for 16 years of my life. We didn't know what the result was, but we knew that I had done the best routine that I could have possibly done. Sticking that first pass set me on this path and this routine where confidence just continued to build. And this dismount, this was the culmination of 16 years of hard work. And I think every cell in my body was committed to that stuck landing. Waiting for the score was tough, but seeing my name ranked in number one was one of the best feelings in the world. As I was waiting and they announced Olympic champion, I just kept thinking, I cannot believe that this is happening right now. As I was standing on the podium, I kept getting these glimpses of my parents and of my coach and of me as a little kid dreaming of this exact moment. And it was one that I felt really, really proud to be Canadian.